Hi, welcome back. I'm Patricia, Patricia Stewart Originals. I'm trying something today. For the first time, I had carved out with my gyro cut these faces. And I want to see how well I can pull prints with them. So, this is my first try, and first I'm going to lay down a few colors. I have here Pyro Orange, Cadmium Yellow. I'm down to the bottom of my yellow. And I will add some green gold. So I will brayer these. I'm going to start by pulling the colors on a plain sheet of computer paper, and I'm working on an 8x10 gel plate. So here I have my colors. Now I'm going to add some teal. Down my faces. A lot of little openings in this face stencil, or probably a mask. A lot of little openings I'm trying to get. Make sure that the paint comes through. Let's see what we got. And yes, it did come through. And I like the colors underneath. So it's good to work with various colors underneath. And these were just some random sketch I did, and making these faces. Now this is really, really stuck to the plate. I'd like to see if I can pull up this ghost print since it's so precise and clear on the plate. I'm trying not to, because I have openings, large openings sometimes, has a tendency to tear. It's fixable with a piece of masking tape, but this is really stuck to the plate. Okay. So I'm going to try some iridescent bronze. And I'm going to try some iridescent copper. To pull that color. It'll be interesting to see how that comes up. I'm just using two colors this time. Now this is interesting. These two colors actually pulled up one of the ghost print. That's interesting. But I'm going to move forward anyway. And I'm going to lay some Payne's Gray down. Lay my mask down. came out well, and you got the shadow in the back of the ghost print, but the print still came out. So a metallic color worked pretty well. And also, my stencil isn't hugging the plate as with the other colors. I guess the metallic is a little looser. I'm just going to use a piece of deli paper to see if I can No, it's really not going to remove the ghost print on here, so I will just keep it moving. The extra lines will make it interesting. So I will try one more, and let's see, I'll try some quinacridone nickel. Kind of translucent. Let's see, I'm trying to stay away from very dark colors. Try some ultramarine violet. Maybe toss just a little yellow. I have no idea what will happen with that. So once again, pull that. And the thing is, when I'm ready and I cut out these faces to use them in a board book, I can embellish and using my Posca pens or Sharpie markers and doodle on them to bring out some of the areas. So here we go. I wasn't going to pull up the ghost print of that last pull, but here the ghost print comes up great. See, you can never really predict what's going to happen. So why mess that up? So that's something I could use. So I will start again and pull using we'll use some cadmium red. Can never tell with these things. I will use some green gold. Maybe Viridian green. It's kind of translucent. that's what we have. So now the question is what to pull as my, as I lay down my mask. Okay, well, I'm going to go, crazy enough, I'm going to go with carbon black. It will either bomb or it won't. We will see. Faces again. Here we go. I don't use the word mess up or the term mess up when I'm gel printing because you learn as you go and it's not necessarily messing up. Wow, that's not bad at all for having the black as background. So all of these different pulls we're able to learn something. And definitely with the black, I like the ghost print. And let's see if we can pull that up. The question is what color? Okay, so it's kind of better if I go with something that is a little translucent and not opaque. And the question is, I will use some Indian yellow. Translucent. And as you can notice, I don't really clean my brayers. I used to spend a lot of time cleaning my brayers. And some of my brayers have a particular rubber that it's very difficult to clean off. And so I've just decided to leave them. I've used pure acetone, which does get them clean, but that could end up damaging the rubber in the long run. So I decided to leave the paint on. And what happens is it builds up to the point where I can peel the whole skin off of it. And you can actually use those skins also in my work. So this is a great pull as well of the ghost print of those faces. So far we've had our first pull, which is good. This was another pull. And then we got a ghost print from that. We pull this, and here's the ghost print from that. So those little faces worked pretty good. Pretty good test run. So maybe you'd want to try your hand at carving out, whether it's butterflies, whether it's faces, something as simple as happy face, whatever it is, and try for yourself. It's just interesting gel print pulls. Thanks for hanging out with me today.